All right, class. Anyone here who knows the answer?
Ligaya, ligaya. Do you know the answer?
Yes, I know, but I'm too shy to speak up. Our classmates might laugh at me.
This happens to many of us almost every day, and some of us lack self-confidence. We wish to change that. My name is Alexis Eugenia, and I have always been passionate in teaching students like you. Together with a team of experts in line with bringing out the best from people, we will show you 9 easy-to-follow techniques in building self-confidence.
So what is self-confidence? Self-confidence is believing and knowing your abilities and values. Also, you are confident as much as you like yourself. Meaning, the more you like yourself, the more confident you become. And the less you like yourself, the less confident you become. So what are the advantages of having self-confidence? Number one, you will have a better life. You will have a happier life. Less regrets, no ill wishes, only love and best intentions. So you will always find yourself appreciated and loved by others. Number two, you can be more successful. Employers prefer employees who are confident because confident people can make firm decisions. Even in business, confident businessmen are more respected. And now we will show you 4 techniques in building your confidence. Let us begin. Number 1. Self-concept. Self-concept is our idea of ourselves and our performance. We have a self-concept on how fast we can run, how good we are as a dancer, and we have a self-concept in almost everything about our lives. So one of the most exciting discoveries in modern psychology is our self-concept has a direct relation with our performance. This also means that whatever idea plays upon our brain, the body will try to live up to it. If my self-concept says that I can run 35 kilometers per hour, chances are I can run 35 kilometers per hour. Remember, you are as confident as much as you like yourself. So one of the keys in developing our self-confidence is to have the idea or expectation that we like ourselves. We can do that by declaring, I like myself, I like myself, I like myself. When you need to have confidence before you meet the person who you really love, before you meet him or her, try saying, I like myself, I like myself, I like myself. When you need to have confidence before you meet the president of a big company and you are nervous, try saying, I like myself, I like myself, I like myself. As a result, you'll place the idea that you like yourself. Remember, you are as confident as much as you like yourself. Therefore, you will become more confident. Number 2, embrace changes. Most people are afraid of changes, because changes may lead to pain and trouble. But the truth is, more often than not, changes will not hurt us. Changes will not bring us trouble. So we strongly recommend to embrace changes. But how do you do that when you are afraid of pain and trouble? It is suggested to begin with small changes. Begin with changes you are certain will not result to pain or trouble. For example, when putting your pants on, let us say that you always begin with your right foot. So starting next week, put your pants on beginning with your left foot. You will find out that this change did not hurt you. Continue doing more changes until your brain subconsciously develops the idea that change will not hurt or result to trouble. Number 3. Learn to handle fear. Fear is an unpleasant emotion in anticipation of pain and trouble. Fear can be a showstopper it can keep you from doing what you are supposed to do. For example, when you need to cross a busy road but many vehicles are speeding, at first glance, you will think that fear is telling you not to cross the road. But if you will listen to what fear is telling you, you will find out that fear is not telling you to not cross the road. Fear is simply telling you to be careful, to stop, look, and listen before you cross the road. Chances are, without fear, a vehicle may have run over us a long time ago. So fear is actually our ally. The opposite words of fear are bravery and courage. So what is the difference between bravery and courage? Bravery is the absence of fear, while courage is doing the right thing even when there is fear. When you are faced with a task that seems to be very difficult and you do not have enough confidence to do the task, ask yourself, is this the right thing to do? If your answer is yes, maybe you will be able to gather enough courage to do what you're supposed to do. Then you will be more confident to accomplish the task. Number 4, greet people before they greet you. To some Filipinos, we do not greet people first because we are concerned that the other person might reject us, and this can be embarrassing. Now, this is called social rejection. Now, it is strongly recommended to greet people before they greet you. Why? If you greet someone, it's either the other person greets you back or rejects you. Now, if the person greets you back, you will feel good. But if the other person ignores you, you will find out that being ignored is not as bad as you thought. So similar to embracing small changes, the message that will subconsciously be sent to your brain is, many things that appear to be bad are not that bad at all. Number 5, visualize. When you need to accomplish a task that is difficult, for example, you need to do a presentation to the president of a big company, it is highly advisable that you visualize positively. In this case, imagine that the president will like you and your presentation very much. Remember that our self-concept has a direct relation with our performance. In other words, whatever idea plays upon your brain, your body will try to live up to it. As a result, subconsciously, you will be more excited and more confident in meeting the president of the big company. Number 6, self-talk. Self-talk is your internal dialogue. It can either result into something positive or negative. It is highly recommended that when you self-talk, face a mirror and begin to talk to yourself positively. When you do a positive self-talk, you are placing a positive idea in your brain. If you have positive ideas in your brain, you will become more confident. Just remember, talk to yourself in the mirror as the second person. So starting tomorrow when you wake up, go to your mirror and start talking positive about yourself. You are cute, you are smart, and you are neat. Number 7, help others. When we help others, we begin to feel our value. Remember, self-confidence is knowing your value. The more people we help, the more valuable we feel. And the more valuable we feel, the more confident we become. Number 8, success folder. Create a folder that will record all your accomplishments. So post in this folder all the accomplishments you have made. So read this folder regularly, especially when you need to build your self-confidence. Number 9, learn to forgive. People who forgive more has the tendency to be more confident. So one of the keys to be confident is to forgive and forgive. Allow us to explain. Imagine yourself as a child between 4 and 5 years old, happily playing in your house. Then suddenly, a visitor of your father came. Your father instructed you, stop playing, be quiet, and go to your room. I have a visitor and it is embarrassing. So you proceeded to your room very sad, with an impression that you are an embarrassment. The brain of the child can be so vulnerable. They absorb almost anything given to them. The thought that you are an embarrassment may linger in your brain as you grow older and older. Therefore, your confidence diminishes. So some of the possible effects are, number one, you will have the tendency not to express yourself because you think that you are an embarrassment. Number two, you begin to question your physical appearance because you think that you can be an embarrassment. So you will need to get rid of this program by going back in time and forgive the people who offended you in the past. How? By trying to understand why they have offended you. In the case of this example, you will need to understand why your father sent you to your room. By doing this, you'll realize that you are not an embarrassment. Your father simply wants the room and wants to be alone with his visitor. The truth is, most of our programs were created during our childhood. Sometimes, we need to go back in time to fix some of our present concerns.
Alright class, anyone here who knows the answer?
Sir, I know the answer!